There you are, you little shit. Are you looking for this?
No. Very funny. You know, you're a real asshole.
What did you just fucking say to me?
Stop it! You're ruining my fucking yoga!
Somebody say yoga?
Trevor?
Michael.
Hey. It's good to see you, man.
Yeah, I bet it is. Of course, I'm not the one that's been resurrected. Ain't this grand, huh?
Yeah, well, I got in a bit of an awkward situation.
You're telling me, bro? Yeah. One of those fake your own deaths to your best buddy, and then run off with the dough, and then live in a big mansion. Awkward situations.
It's one way of looking at it.
Yeah, do you have any other ways of looking at it? Because I am all out.
Look, it was a long time ago, man. I've been in witness protection. I still am. That's great. That's great.
I'm sorry. Where are my manners, right? Amanda, it is good to see you. Oh, I missed you. You used to be fatter. Nice new tits, by the way. Jimmy, you used to be thinner, but can't blame you. Who are you?
Namaste. I'm Fabienne.
Good Lord. Where's Tracy?
Where's your sister, Jim?
She's trying out for TV.
She's what?
Yeah, she's auditioning for Fame or Shame.
Fame or Shame?
The fuck are you talking about?
You know, it's that talent / skills show. She loves it, you guys know that.
What's her talent?
Dancing.
Oh, Christ, she's a horrible dancer.
Michael!
She might disagree with you on that.
Jesus Christ, what, now? Now? Where?
The Maze Bank Arena.
Oh, little Tracy being humiliated. Let's go, we go get her.
We?
Yeah, we. What, are you gonna stand here and argue while your daughter becomes a national laughingstock? Huh? You're worse than I thought. Now let's go, come on!
All right.
So, Mike, what were you doing?
I was making myself a juice. Broccoli, raw kale, fish oil. This recipe I got is packed with nutrients, fibers, vitamins, and it don't taste bad. I'll send you the recipe. Anyway, get this. I'm making it. The blender slips, juice goes everywhere. I'm about to clean it up when I find this bag of grass. Big fucking bag, Jimmy's, right? Okay, just that moment, Amanda comes in. Sees me there with.
I didn't ask for a blow-by-blow of how you lost your last ounce of masculine pride. I wanted to know what you've been doing for a decade.
Easy, T.
Don't T me.
Hey, if anyone needs kale, my friend.
I'm beyond pale, okay? It's too late for kale, and its magical powers to have any effect on me.
Fine.
Or yoga, or talk therapy. I'm a crank, cannibalism, an incest kind of guy.
Oh, don't worry, T. They'd skip that talk and go straight to shock treatment with your ass.
You two chilled out to say my name, you fat slob. You two relaxed, and you laid back Los Santos embarrassment, huh? Is one letter all you can bring yourself to wrap your slothful lips around?
Whoa, dude. You do not let the fuck up.
I've got 10 years worth of venting to do. The let up, my friend, is a long way off.
Fine, fine. Do what the fuck you want.
Want? Well, I want to save your daughter from making...
Don't kill me!
Come on.
These spaces are reserved for production vehicles.
Come on, you dipshit. That host, man, he's like any closeted TV presenter. Bitter as fucking vinegar.
Where the fuck are they?
Hello, sir. May I please have your names?
Where the fuck is Tracy Townley, huh? Tracy fucking DeSanta. Fuck, screw that! Where the fuck's Laszlo?
It doesn't matter. It is me, quiet.
All right. Yeah. That was really good. All right. It's the auditions, Fame or Shame, season 14, right here in Vinewood, San Andreas. Coming up next, it's Tracy DeSanta. Judges, Tracy DeSanta. Yes.
Hi.
All right. Tracy's a dancer, but she also likes acting, modeling, and working with children. That's beautiful. You're so original, like a basket full of puppies or a rainbow or a pile of puke.
Oh.
Who are these clowns?
That's my dad and Trevor?
Two dads. Great.
Wow.
Very San Andreas.
What are you guys doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
Okay, I'm back.
Relax, chill, make yourself at home. He's got a little show to do here.
Okay.
Three, two, one. All right, it's Fame or Shame for Tracy DeSanta. Music!
When I came home last night, you wouldn't make love to me. You went fast asleep.
Yeah.
You wouldn't even talk to me.
Take what your daddy's gave you, honey.
I'm so crazy.
Ooh, it does. Stuff a 20 in this.
Fucking
do something about this.
That's enough.
Oh, I said that's enough. Hey, I got security. Security!
What'd you fucking
say? Come on, big guy. Come on there.
No.
Fuck.
No.
Come here, you little shit.
No.
Go home right now, Tracy. I just want to talk to you. Told us. We gotta take the truck.
There! We take the truck!
I got a deposit on that truck!
We're running that prick down.
Hey, take a left up here.
How can you sit there and watch your daughter get treated like that?
Hey, you raise a daughter in this town, you get used to stunts.
It's poor parenting.
Now, thanks for the fucking feedback. It means a lot coming from you.
No one's getting in the way of the big rig!
We'll flatten this big bag. Fucking Laszlo. I knew he was an asshole.
Just push him off the fucking road! It's only a battery car, come on!
This ain't exactly a racer.
Look! He went left! Ah, the little bastard's gone onto the train tracks! We can have a little fun with him, but let's not try to kill this prick, all right?
When we crush his little toy car, who knows what'll happen to him?
He took a left!
I knew this city would be full of douchebags.
Can we speed it up a little, huh?
Maybe by throwing your fat carcass over the side.
He's gone round to the right. Right, right here. Can't get enough of the celebrities, can you? 10 fucking minutes in L.S.
Shut up! That cocksucker might be famous, but You'll get him! You'll get him!
But we're sure taking our time about it. He's going down into the L.S. River.
I can see that. I hate that closeted man whore on the TV. I hate him on the radio. I hate him even more in person. He was never funny.
The little shit's all out of juice.
Hey, guys.
You run out of batteries, huh?
I didn't mean anything by it, all right?
Oh, yeah? Well, that little girl sat on my lap when she was 2 years old, and I swore to God that I would rip the fucking skin off anyone who fucking wronged her.
Look, I'm just a dumb A-list celebrity trying to entertain America, okay? I got a lot of stuff going on right now, dude, besides you trying to kill me. Now I got multiple sexual harassment lawsuits, plus I'm an addict, all right? And I've relapsed. I can't stop jacking, dude. I jack it in traffic.
What's your talent, huh? I mean, aside from love and sex.
Dude, haven't you seen my show? It's not live, it's not funny. That's my genius. I got no fucking talent.
You clearly ain't being humble, T. You proved your point.
This is your daughter. You should be wanting to rip the fucking ponytail off the back of this guy's head. And you! Pants off.
Okay.
There you go. All right.
What are you doing?
Now, I want you to dance sexy, celebrity.
I mean, I need music or...
Are you trying to fucking annoy me, huh?
I'll dance.
Good. All right, all right. Now drop it like it's hot, all right? I want to see you get nice and low. Come on, lower, lower, come on.
Oh, please don't kill me, okay? I'm supposed to be on a magazine cover next week.
All right, come on, get off. Take off, go, now, before I change my mind.
I got it all on my camera, you fucking pussy. The world's gonna see your shit.
I'm going home.
How the fuck did you do it without me for 9 years, huh?
Oh, shit.
Dave.
We need to talk.
I was about to tell you the same thing.
Okay. Meet me at Galileo Observatory as soon as you can get there.
Okay. Hey, Lester.
Mike, hey, I'm transferring your cut of the jewel store take to your account. Madrazo's already got the house money, so you can rest easy there.
Ah, thank God for that.
Well, I'm like crazy busy with all these meetings and venture capitalists these days. Fucking
ass. Idiota! Move, move, let's move!
Shit!
Ah. Yo, I'm recording this!
Oh! Shit!
Message for me, get off your fat ass.
See, this exercise stuff's about as relaxing for you as it is for my wife.
No, I don't want to sleep with you, and no, I don't care that I'm 39 and single. It doesn't worry me a bit.
Easy.
I'm not stressed out at all. Now go fuck yourself.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay. Just fuck you. All of you. I'm on a run.
Yeah, well, you seem a little upset.
I could still run you into the fucking ground.
Okay. Hey. I played high school football, all right, sweetheart? All-state, QB.
Whatever. Just don't have a coronary. Let's go!
Whoa!
Okay, ma'am boobs, race you to the beach! I don't know who I'm more embarrassed for. You're not exactly dressed for cardio.
It's running. How much gear do you need?
I feel like I'm being chased by my creepy uncle.
Yeah, if your uncle was the same age as you mean? Although that would explain a lot.
Fuck you!
Why are you so angry?
I'm not angry! I'm exercising! Run on the road! Take that traffic head on!
Yeah, I could have guessed you were one of those.
That space is yours! Own it! It's called exercise, you lazy idiots! Excuse me for walking? You broke my cadence, you fucking moron!
Wow!
Sorry about the Neanderthal!
Oh, excuse me.
Age rage firing on all cylinders! This must be so emasculating for you. Okay, here we go. Last push. Come on, flick the switch, Marianne. Let's go lactic!
I thought I had issues, but you give me hope.
I own you!
My shrink's office is right near here if you want to work through some of that shit.
Yeah, because you're a walking advertisement for therapy.
Am I the only one who works for
a living? We should go to the dungeon crawler. All the celebs go there.
Yeah! Red light! Oh!
Oh! Not too shabby, huh?
You can have that one on me. I never got out of second gear. I already did a 10K today.
Yeah, whatever gets you through it. Oh, my chest. Fuck me.
Screw you! You're lucky I'm tapering for a try!
Sorry.
Hey, you finally called. I was like a friend for Kim.
My computer's ready?
Strange. No one even looks where they're going.
Wow!
Hostia!
Hey, Trace, what's up?
What's up? Are you joking? You ruined my life.
I did? I thought I'd already ruined your life. Remember after that boat thing?
Take this seriously! Do you know how bad I wanted that? Fame or shame is, like, an amazing opportunity! You're such a fucking fuck, you really are!
You'll get over it. You'll see, I did you a favor.
Never! I hate you!
Excuse me, sir. Can I talk to you for a second?
The fuck are you talking about?
I am talking about a hotline straight to heaven
that this state makes illegal.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about.
I don't give a fuck about reefer.
They rigged the vote. I saw the ballots. It's a lie.
It's democracy at work, amigo.
Democracy can suck my fatty. Democracy only works when it lets intelligent people do what they want. This is tyranny by morons.
Yeah, well, they got things to take care of in a little place called reality.
You want a drag?
Nah, I'm not a drug guy.
This isn't bushweed. This is mana. And I grow it myself. No paranoia, no weirdness. A passport to nirvana.
Fuck, give me this.
Yeah, here, you'll hardly feel it. Yeah, I smoke all day, and I'm fine. It's a pure, mellow high. But I do get concerned about the monsters. Yeah. I mean...
I'm sure they're nothing serious, but, I never let them get too near.
Oh, the fuck is that?
Oh, shit! What is going on?
After that, you see, the liquor companies push for continued prohibition, which is complete insanity. So I take it I can count on your support.
The fuck just happened?
What are you talking about? We discussed globalization, the state.
Stay the fuck away from me.
But it's a good cause.
Man, you got off lucky, homie.
That motherfucker.
Hey, whoa, back off there, cowboy. I know my constitutional rights. Anyway, I know you're coming here to suck cock, so it's all right.
What the fuck you talking about?
Whoa, hey, look, I saw Quarterback Blues, man. And, you know, some of those older records of yours, even they sound a little bit closeted, I'm just saying.
What? A black man walking in Vinewood, you think he Clay PG sellout? You bitch-ass punk motherfucker.
Oh, shit, man. Oh, hey, I'm sorry, dude. I didn't have my contacts in, you know? I mean, I love black people. Yeah, you know, like... I love gangsters. I love, like, gangster rap. Yo, sup?
Man, who gives a fuck if he's gay or not, man? The man is not married. It's his business. Leave motherfuckers alone.
Well, look, I'm just saying that it's the hypocrisy that I can't stand. You know, I mean, of celebrities. I mean, PG, right? He says he's a killer and a murderer and all that great stuff. And then, what, he loves his mother and likes show tunes. I mean, really, what kind of message does that send in our kids? You know what I'm saying? The guy's a fraud.
But why do you care, man?
Yeah, because, you know why? Because they all think they're gods, right? Well, fuck them! They're not magic. No, they're no better than me. Shit. Oh, shit. Oh, my God, it's Miranda. Miranda, I love you, Miranda! Come on! Come on, it's fucking Miranda fucking Cowan! Because she's a fucking megastar!
No, leave me out your shit, man.
Oh, no. We can make boku bucks here, man. We get one picture of her hairy legs or her aging muff, and we are in the money, man. In the money, bro. Come on, man.
What the fuck is wrong with me?
Let's go. You drive, I'll get the shot. Go. Get us right up alongside that limo. Come on.
Hey.
He's got it.
He's a whore.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, give me more. I don't believe it. She's slamming a speedball in there, man. This is journalistic gold. You know you want it, Cowan. You're a fucking man. Look at you. It's in the public interest, you homewrecker. Man, they don't call her the silicone slattern for nothing. She looks like a bloodhound in a wind tunnel. God, I love her.
Oh, man, no wonder this whole town's in therapy.
Well done on the rehab. Not! Hey, here, you bitch!
We done yet?
No, she still looks too good! I want the prisoner of war shot! That's where the big zeros are! Homewrecker! Harlot! Oh, you're human, you bitch! Okay, let's go again! We need the money shot!
Fuck you, Beverly! This one's mine!
Oh, no! It's that bottom feeder, Madison! Shit, he's getting the money shots! Where's your dignity, man? Forget Miranda! We can't let him steal my exclusive! Get alongside him! I'll knock the weasel off! Stay on that bastard! He fell off! What an amateur!
What a failure! I made six figures last year!
Uh-oh! Looks like you wrecked your camera, Madison! Okay, buddy, let's get out of here. I'm already late for another stakeout.
There's a small parking lot by the Cafe Redemption Courtyard in Morningwood.
All right, homie. It's been an education, dawg. Look, keep on making the world a better place, you hear me?
Yeah, the public needs to know. The fans deserve answers.
Shit, not if the question is how low is Miranda Collins' muff hanging or if she getting banged out by some second-rate director.
They need to know everything, from crow's feet to camel toes. Hey. Come by the manor next week.
We'll continue the search for the truth.
Look, don't wait around for me, homie.
Oh, I'm waiting for you, homie.
Shit!
It's just a car, babe!
Shit, dude! Ah!
That is beyond the pale.
One more day, and I'm a retired man. Corn and potato chips. Morning, noon, and night. What the hell? Help! Somebody, I'm trapped! I can smell gas! Get me out of here! Use that bulldozer to move the pipes! And hurry, please! It stinks of gas in here! Hurry up! We don't have long! Hurry, please! I smell burning! Oh, God, I'm not gonna make it! Come on! Come on! Get back! She's gonna go! Run! It's gonna blow!
Out the car, nigga.
You got off lucky, homie.
-9-zeta-3x.
Wait! Stop!
What's the problem, homie?
Wait.
Carbon-based life form, check. 6 feet tall, check. Slightly excessive adipose tissue. Normal distribution, check. Readings are... Shoot. This little machine is broken again, check. Stardate 14-9-305, time is 7:89 past the ninth meridian. We are clear. Whew, greetings, CBL, carbon-based life form.
Greetings, homie.
Have you seen them, CBL?
Seen who?
I don't know.
They came to me last week. There was a brilliant joy and a terrible confusion. And they were laughing and screaming and crying all at once. And some said, Omega, we come in peace. And others said, we have come to enslave you. We are an infinitely intelligent race of supercosmic beings, and out of the 6 billion people on this planet, we have chosen you for no good reason. And just then, they were about to abduct me and do experiments on me when their ship crashed.
Man, you done lost your motherfucking mind.
And now, I've got to find the pieces.
Man, bullshit.
Look. See this? If you see some, let me know.
Yeah, okay, I will, man.
Resuming data scan.
What a freak!
High ground. Good thinking, T.
Dios mío, ¿qué pasa?
Miss!
Move!
Treasure trove.
That's a perfectly good sock.
Just ignore us.
Yes, don't mind us. Pretend we're not here.
Okay.
You're not Jock Cranley, are you? Actor and artist? I love your work. Oh, stunt double? Oh, our favorite show. Mrs. Thornhill, snap!
Watch the birdie.
Oh, pretend to throttle me. Yeah, yeah, like you did on that poster you did.
Yeah, okay, well, that would be my pleasure.
Oh.
Like that, huh?
Yeah? Oh.
Maybe something like this? Or like that? Huh? You like that?
That's enough, huh? Dear.
You like that?
Stop! Ooh. Please!
Oh, hey. Oh.
Thank you.
Wow, that's quite a woman there, huh? Oh.
We are not worthy. We're not worthy.
We're not worthy.
I'm not Jock, what's his name?
Cranley. Big star in the 80s.
We love celebs. Oh. That's why we came to Tinseltown.
Yes. Before we met you, we were trying to break in to Bruce Spade's house and steal his rubbish.
The things these stars throw away. Oh. They're not like you or me.
Mrs. Thornhill has the most unbelievable collection of celebrity underwear and bathroom products. Things they've actually used themselves.
You guys have a great vacation, all right? I gotta go.
We could do with some help. All this climbing over walls and rooting through bins, it's such a business. Nigel's got an arthritic knee. Yeah.
What do you need?
Just a few vinewood souvenirs for my museum.
Look at this map. I mean, a lot of these places have famous people living in them and some that are just hanging about. Bring us some things. I'd be very thankful indeed.
Americans are the most wonderful people in the world, aren't they?
The best!
Such fun!
Ah, a pair of fruitcakes.
That was close.
Give me a ride. I can't do it. I can't marry him.
In that case, jump on board.
Just get me out of here, please. I live in Vinewood Hills, Kimball Hill Drive. Oh, God, thank you so much. I was starting to think nobody was going to stop. People see a girl screaming in a wedding dress and they assume, crazy! He's the crazy one, not me. Talk about anger issues. Oh, my God. No, I think that's him. He's coming after me.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Leave me alone! I'm done with you!
You're done where I say you're done.
Get me away from him, please. I can't go back there.
You know, I think you can do better.
That dress makes you look fat.
I never want to see you or your mother again! Buddy. Oh, finally. Now please take me home. I can't wait to get out of this stupid dress.
Anything for the bride on her special day.
Something borrowed.
Anything for the bride on her special day.
I should never have let it go this far. Oh, God. What's my dad going to say? He spent 10 grand just on ice sculptures for the reception. We had these cute little cell phone covers made with our photo on them. It was going to be so fabulous.
I can only imagine.
Oh, God. I hope they don't make me give back the gifts. Ugh, whatever. Anything to be rid of him. And at least I lost all that weight.
What did you ever see in that guy?
On paper, he was perfect. Rich, successful, the big car, the house in Vinewood Hills. And he was nice to me sometimes after the rages. I thought I could change him. Are you married?
No. If you can believe it, nobody snapped me up yet.
And I know he did some hooker on his bachelor party, but he just kept smiling and talking about his stupid bro pass. You know, he told me once that infidelity doesn't count out of state. Well, guess who's got the honeymoon tickets? Two can play at that game. I might even get pregnant. I'll have some Greek waiter's baby, see how he likes that. There was no way I was having kids with that Neanderthal. The thought of perpetuating his DNA, ugh, I couldn't do that to the world.
He really let one get away with you, didn't he?
You should see his friends. They were all there, hungover, grinning like a bunch of slow kids at a petting zoo. I have never met bigger douchebags in my life. I would literally rather disembowel myself with a jagged piece of glass than play hostess to those morons ever again. And his mother? Of course I could never live up to her, could I? The way he ran around after her and her prolapse. I seriously think some weird stuff went down with those two. I bet he used to bathe her.
Wow. You tell it like it is, don't you?
Anyway, I don't want to talk about him anymore. I just want this all to be over. Thank you so much. Look out! You saved me from the worst decision of my life.
What the
out
hell?
Out you get, buddy!
Oh, crap.
You're gonna meet a bitch, that's where you're gonna meet one, you know what I'm saying?
Hey.
Give me a sip of that.
What?
Come on! My throat's dry as a motherfucker.
Why? Is your mother dry when you're...
What the fuck is that, huh?
Nothing.
Well, it didn't sound like nothing, all right? It didn't seem like nothing. I don't think that it was nothing.
Look, I didn't mean nothing by it, old man.
Old man? Old man!
Fuck you, you creepy old motherfucker! That's right. I said it. Creepy. Old. Motherfucker!
No! Jesus.
Huh?
No, come on.
What?
Sorry.
Now, where
sorry.
Were we on, exactly,
get up,
huh?
Get up. Ah. I'm sorry, man. We're
Help,
sorry.
Man. Help!
Shithead!
Shot? Fuck!
Old man! What the hell's this for an old man?
You're
Hey, bud. What you do?
Nothing. What you up to, Cletus?
Hunting.
Hunting what? Retirees?
Nah, just stuff. Windows, antenna, tires,
vermin.
Ah, so that was you. 'Tis the season for it.
I don't give a shit about no season.
Oh, good, huh? Don't let the regulations get you down.
That's what I'm saying. Hey, you want to come hunting with me? It'd be real neighborly of you.
Hell, why not?
All right, then. Up here with you. I got just a thing. Let's raise some hell, neighbor.
Oh, I'm in.
I'll introduce you to one of my all-time favorite pastimes.
You're gonna love this.
Okay, you see them three big satellite dishes? A decent shot, and they'll go down easier than a whore's drawers.
You're a real pillar of the community.
Half the folks in this town would sell their own mother, and most of the other half already did. Screw them. Yeah, that's it. Give them hell. Shoot another one. No more reality. Boom! Didn't I tell you this would be more fun than a barrel full of pussies?
Ooh, you're a classy date, Cletus. No denying that.
Now drive us up to that abandoned motel. I got an even better idea.
So, what now?
We're gonna try our luck on something less stationary.
Ooh, liberals?
Nothing as slippery as that. You'll see.
You've got way too much time on your hands.
Nah, this is just a bit of foolery. I've been busier than hell with the real hunting. The money in wild organic meat these days, you wouldn't believe. Them hipsters will give you their parents' last dime for it. It's gotten so I can't even keep up with the demand no more. All this eat local, small batch, farm-to-table bullshit. Here we are. I bet you never shut out the tires on a car before?
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Well, let's see what you got then.
Ain't you gonna shoot anything, Cletus?
Nah, I do this all the time, and I wanna see how you deal with a moving target. This is perfect right here. Pick a car and shoot a tire. Good, plain, old-fashioned fun.
Hellfire!
Cars don't burst. Shoot the tires. Nice! Go on, one more, just for the hell of it. That's it, beauty! In again, Trevor.
I never knew you were such an agitator, Cletus.
All these damn tourists coming out here to gawp at rednecks. Give them what they want, I say. Man, not too bad, Trevor. Right, let's change it up. Come on, follow me.
Hey!
Just two fellers killing time in small town America. Don't get much better than this, does it?
The two most popular guys in town.
Am I glad I ran into you? Ain't nowhere near this fun being antisocial on your own.
Whatever cranks your tractor, I say. What's up next on the hillbilly anarchist agenda?
Ever saw anything with a face? Actually, let me ask it again. Ever shot anything with a face on four legs?
Now, Cletus, it's important you realize I'm a man plagued by vicious rumors.
Fine. Let's head for the roof. I seen some coyotes hanging around down by the road. Reckon it would be real neighborly of us to get rid of a couple.
And we are nothing if not neighborly.
We'll get a better shot from up here. See him. Looks like we got two packs of coyotes down there. Take a few of them out, and the rest should scatter. Damn, you're shaking like a dog pooping peach pits.
What?
That should do it. Nicely done. I reckon you should tag along next time I go hunting out at Polito Bay. I'll show you how to bag an elk.
Why not?
All right, gotta go. I'll send you a text when I'm about. You're no redneck!
There you are, handsome.
Hello, Maud.
How have you been?
Oh, simply wonderful. And you?
About the same. Somewhere stuck between joyful and peachy. Even in this world full of scum and detritus, it's only right that we all bear our share.
Ain't that the truth?
Take this poor wretch on the run, desperate, alone, about to learn the true meaning of suffering, all for a few thousand bucks. Think you can find him for me?
Every man has his talents, Maud, and the rigorous administration of justice is one of mine.
That's why I love you, Trevor. I'll send you his file.
You're not an FIB agent. You don't get to know where I am all day. Jesus.
You are really pathetic, Michael. Pathetic.
Yep.
Some fucking manners would be nice.
Buddy!
course.
You know I've got a competition coming up. Look, can we talk about this inside?
That's it.
Walk away like you always do. Hey, you. Listen, can you give me a ride? My wife's gone crazy. I'll throw some dollars your way.
Yeah, I would if I had a vehicle to give you a ride in. Let me see what I can do.
Okay, I'll wait here and take a good long look at my life, strewn all over the front yard. Thanks, man. Just let me grab my favorite iron. Just not getting that. What a mess. A really great wardrobe out for all to see. Whatever. I can't deal with it right now. Can you drop me off at the golf club in Richmond? At least I know I'll be welcome there.
So, you're just gonna leave all your stuff in the driveway?
Yeah, I'm not giving her the satisfaction of cleaning that up. I'll go to the club, get a few drinks in me, and hope either her meds have kicked in or the gin is worn off by the time I get back. I appreciate you doing this, by the way. I know it's kind of a weird one. What's your name?
Michael.
Good to meet you. I'm Castro.
What is that? Italian? Spanish?
Pure wasp, I'm afraid. My sister's called Muffy, so I think I got off lightly.
Look out! So, what was that all about?
Just the usual psycho female stuff. She thinks I've got another woman on the side.
And do you?
That's not the point. She doesn't know that I have one. Okay, guy to guy now. I have a very strict code. Only on out-of-town trips, no real names, a dead trail. That's a gentle. If you just drop me off at the entrance here, that'd be great. Thanks again. Hey, we should play golf sometime. Come by the club. I'm here most days.
Davey, how you doing?
About as good as can be expected. But the news is not good.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I know you did that fucking jewelry job.
Davey, seriously, you're imagining things.
Fuck you.
All right. I did it. Arrest me. You know what? You'll be saving my life. Because you called it, motherfucker.
What?
You called it.
Trevor.
Couple days ago. But we haven't really talked about anything either.
But if no when, He starts asking questions about why you're not feeding worms south of the Canadian border.
Oh, we got problems.
Yeah, no shit.
We're in it.
Together.
So, if your problems are my problems, then I guess that means that my problems are sort of your problems.
Nope.
What if I lose my job? Someone comes into my office, starts reading my files. They'll see the things I did. I know a lot of stuff. I can cop a plea, get 5 years, but you...
Fuck you, you ungrateful prick. I made your career.
Well, then we better go about saving it together, because you and I both know we can't let it go to shit now.
What do you need?
This guy, Ferdinand Karamov. The agency claims he's dead. We at the Bureau think they're full of crap. We think he's being debriefed someplace.
So?
Apparently, he has information which will put me and my superiors out of circulation. Those agency fuckers have got the coroner's office locked down. We need you to verify the body.
So how the hell am I gonna get in here?
Well, you've played dead before, haven't you? I have always kind of liked you. Call me when you wake up. I'll tell you what to do.
What we got?
John Doe, white male, overweight, in his late 40s, possible coroner.
Let's take a peek.
The fat deposits on his hips and abdomen suggest a fondness for bleeder burgers.
We're probably about to find one in his gut, still in its wrapper.
Right next to the bottle of scotch and pack of Redwoods. See the broken capillaries around the nose?
Ah! Oh, Jesus!
God! Back from the dead, motherfucker!
Come out! Hands in the air! Come on. Might be in the other room. Give it up! Surrender yourself!
That don't look right. Guess you can't judge a corpse by its toe tag. I found the toe tag. Ferdinand Karamov. It's on some big black lady. Definitely not your guy.
Okay. The agency have the lower floors on lockdown to prevent a leak. I got a guy who can cut the power to give you some help. But you'll have to get upstairs if you're gonna get out.
We're locked down. Gotta take the stairs.
No one comes in or out.
I don't know what's going on here, but I want the fuck out. I should have stayed on the slab. Once today.
It's over. Man down. Man down. You're done. You
hear this? Is fuck.
We've got protocol, motherfucker.
Carry on with your business.
Hey, Mike.
F. Hey, we need to talk. Quick, meet me at those oil derricks just outside town, El Burro Heights. And make sure you're not tailed.
Man, that don't sound too good, homie. Look, I'm on my way.
You entitled piece of shit! Dave, the hell was that? You know how many spooks I just ran into?
I'm sorry. They're not nice people, if that's a consolation.
What's going on?
There's a big target out there, something in the shadows. The data algorithms are reading off the charts. Whoever finds it, the Bureau or the agency, is gonna get a big bump in funding.
Like I care about your funding. I'm out, Dave.
You're not. I need you to meet my boss. We'll be downtown in the plaza between the FIB and the IAA buildings.
The IAA buildings? You fucking kidding me after the spat I just had with those agency men?
Relax. They won't be looking there. They never expect an inside job.
Franklin.
What's going on?
You gotta get out of town.
Man, I ain't exactly got nowhere to go.
Well, then take a trip. A long trip.
What the fuck is going on?
Things, all right? Look, you remember I told you I know people? Feds who looked after me when I retired?
You did?
Yeah, I did. I mean, I think I did. I don't know. Shit, Jesus Christ, Franklin. I got so many stories, I can't even keep them straight. I'm full of shit.
Yeah, but your full of shit got me a lot of paper. One score with you, I made more money than I ever did hustling.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I'm a great thief, but you know, it's the other shit that I ain't got figured out.
So what's the deal, man? What's the deal with the Bureau, man?
This clown, I mean, he's an okay guy, fucking cocksucker. We did a deal a long time ago. It didn't go quite the way it was supposed to go. Wrong guy got killed, so I had to go into kind of an informal witness protection program. He helped me, I didn't reveal secrets of his, and everything was cool. The problem started when recently I became unretired. I mean, he shows up, starts calling in favors, telling me to do shit. I mean, look, Franklin, I'm working for the fucking feds.
Oh, fuck, man.
Oh, fuck, man, yeah, and that ain't even the worst part. Did I ever tell you about Trevor?
Man, I think so, shit.
Well, if you only think so, then I wasn't being completely honest. He's, hell walking on Earth. That's what he is.
Well, let's bury this motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, good luck with that.
Shit.
I mean, Trevor and I got history. Complicated fucking history. Look, I've done a lot of things that I ain't proud of. Okay, I never claimed to be an angel. But you meet Trevor, Franklin, you'll swear I am an angel.
So what's the mood here, man?
I don't know. Fuck. I'm just gonna, you know, try to play both sides. You know, until I can find a way out of this shit.
All right, man, look, man, you help me. The way I see it, man, the least I can do is help you.
It's a death sentence, Franklin.
Man, I ain't trying to hear all that shit, man. If the Bureau ain't gonna take you to court, them motherfuckers just hustlers anyway. And I ain't finna let no motherfucking cat think he's so motherfucking crazy run me up a tree. Fuck that.
Hey, you're a good kid, Franklin. This means a lot to me. Like I told you, I'm a terrific thief. I'll find something for you. Big. Now, come on. You better take off.
All right, man. I'm with you. I'm with you.
Yeah, you enjoying yourself now, huh? Forgive me, but my knees is greater than yours.
Take it easy, I got you. There's gotta be a hospital near here somewhere.
No! No hospitals! Can you take me to Sandy Shores? I got people there who can help me out. Chola Springs Avenue. Look, thanks for this. Another 20 seconds, I'd have had the cops all over me.
What the hell happened back here?
Don't worry about it, okay? It's not worth it.
Look, you bleeding out. You won't go to the hospital or the cops. And you fleeing the scene of a dead body. If you want my help, you're gonna have to do better than that.
Just a job that went wrong. Trust me, don't wanna know.
Trust me, I do. I've seen enough jobs go wrong. I wanna be clear what I'm getting into.
So you're in the game?
Now who's asking too many questions?
Look, we hit a pawn shop, okay? But it was a sting. Cops were waiting for us. It was supposed to be an easy job, low risk, 20K each. I was the driver.
And not a very good
one. Hey, I got us through three roadblocks. We had half of San Andreas law enforcement on our ass. We'd have been home free if that son of a bitch hadn't pulled a blade on me at 100 miles per hour. Spun us off the road. You cross me, I put you down. No second chances.
Sounds like you need to find a better crew.
Considering I got two in custody and the other one dead on the side of Sonora Freeway, I need any crew, period. Why? You know someone?
Nah, I didn't say that.
They got nothing to connect me. No real names, no addresses. Left all the money. Way too hot to wash. I'll get myself patched up, lie low at the safe house for a day or two, then see what I can put together. Man, that's a lot of blood.
I'ma get you there as fast as I can.
This is it. Listen, I ain't sure what you're into, but you need a driver anytime, you let me know.
Oh!
dumb luck right there.
I know a super chill place on Haywick Ave.
Oh, the Spalky. I get really
Oh,
shaved.
Yeah, I know the guy there. I get the special treatment, you know. Well, I'm like crazy busy with all these meetings with venture capitalists these days. Fucking assholes.
Hey.
Tell you what, let me think about it and get back to you, right?
Start, you piece
Later.
Of crap.
I'm having an okay vacation.
Tell that little shit that a pound of grass a week and no job don't add up to achievement in my book.